at the time that I was boxing, I was also in an abusive relationship that I was in. I was 18. Well, I started when I was 19, but from 18 to 21, I was with this individual who was physically, verbally, emotionally, and spiritually abusive. And boxing really helped me. It helped me in so many ways. It helped me to get out of the abusive relationship. It helped me to better my grades and to get a newfound focus on life and a real direction. And it also taught me about health and how to take care of my body. Relationship too, you kind of, and the fact that I got out of it gave me a self-empowerment as a woman to not fear men, because I could either, there's two things that can happen in an abusive relationship. You can either get out and feel empowered like I did, or you can fear men for the rest of your life and be afraid of your own shadow. And you know what, I chose the other route. I said no, I'm not gonna let that happen to me. So when I got into the ring, I didn't fear anybody. And I've been hit by a man. I was hit by a 260-pound man, full force in the face, 8 stitches above my eyebrow. You know what, if I could take that kind of punch, I felt like I could take anything in the ring. You know, this time more calculated. Really slow, just I was a smoker. I had quit smoking. So I was in the worst condition, you know, ever to get into boxing, but I did it slowly. I got on the bike first. I would do a half an hour minimum on the bike every day. Then I finally felt that I felt like my legs were strong enough and my my lungs were strong enough to be able to get on the treadmill, I would start to run. You know, I had to lose some weight too. You know, I had to gain some muscle because your legs are carrying you. You can't just, you know, go start running and you're gonna run 5 miles. You can't. You know, you have to rely on those muscles, that when one muscle gets tired, you got to learn how to use another one so that you can keep the run going. So it took some time, but it was a determination, you know, and a lot of patience, a lot of patience. Hector's like a father to me. I mean, I see him more than I see my own parents, you know. I'm very close to my parents as well, but I'm here. And, you know, I guess it's, you know, you can apply anything to life. Like if you're working or you're doing something, I'm going to school, or I have problems in my personal life. You have your parents to fall back on. You know, you go to them for advice and stuff. In the ring, Hector's my father. So in between rounds, I go to my father for help in the corner.
Make him come, Donna, make him come. Donna, make him come, please. Go, go. Right, go, smart. You're winning the fight. That's it, yeah, and go. Right, that's it. Ba, 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 and move. Right, that's it, make it work. Beautiful. Right, that's it.
My goal for boxing is to, you know, become a world champion, you know, maybe multiple time world champion, and really to pave a road, a way for women in boxing, especially for the amateurs, you know, and especially for the females here in New York. You know, I was fortunate enough to be the first female to fight on Lou DiBella's Broadway Boxing, you know, and then after that, other promoters started putting females on their cards as well, which, you know, I hope that helped for them to see that the females can fight too and give us an equal chance.